There was a knock on the door by a righteous Gentile who told my father not to go to the synagogue that day.
75 years ago, a wave of anti-Jewish violence erupted throughout Germany.
By 11 o'clock, we were on our way to running away.
Stormtroopers and Hitler Youth units, dressed in everyday clothes, destroyed synagogues and Jewish-owned homes and businesses. The goal, to paint the destruction as a spontaneous act of public outrage.
The minute we hit the pavement, my sister and I got hysterical. We were screaming.
This destruction, known as Kristallnacht, or the Night of Broken Glass, marked the first time the Nazi regime arrested Jews on a large scale, based solely on their religious background or ethnicity.
And I remember the grayness and the smell was the smoke from the burning synagogue, and we must have seen the fire.
The U.S. Holocaust Memorial Museum commemorated the anniversary by giving survivors like Jill a chance to tell their stories.
All three speakers at this morning's program were actually women from Montgomery County who are survivors of Kristallnacht.
Jill says this night was a horrendous warning to the world of what was going to happen.
We were living a very abnormal life for a child. I was never allowed on the street.
But through a child's eyes, it wasn't all bad.
I was extremely lucky in that situation because there was another little girl in the house, my age, and we blocked out the whole world and its problems, and we played from morning till night.
Thankfully, this story has a happy ending. Jill has lived in Silver Spring for over 40 years and says today, life is good. At the Holocaust Memorial Museum, Christina Gaddy, CNS-TV.